Ahead of the Modi's meeting with President Donald Trump, India today met the families of martyrs who laid down their lives in Kashmir in the hands, out of the hands of the Pakistan-backed terrorists. All bereaved families want is justice. Take a look.
Ten days ago, Firoz Dar, an SHO posted in Anantnag, was shot dead and mutilated along with five other Jammu and Kashmir policemen. The perpetrators were Lashkar terrorists, and clearly their motive to intimidate locals has backfired.
हमारे बच्चों को इंसाफ चाहिए हम उसको वापस तो नहीं ला सकते हैं पर हम ये चाहते हैं कि हमें इंसाफ चाहिए कश्मीर को इंसाफ चाहिए
Dar wasn't the only local lad killed by terrorists. Lieutenant Umar Fayaz was abducted and killed earlier, and then last Thursday DSP Mohammed Ayub Pandit was lynched by a mob fueled by separatists outside Srinagar's Jamia Mosque.
मुझे नहीं मालूम था कि उन्होंने मेरे हस्बैंड को क्या कर रहे हैं मेरी दुनिया उजाड़ कर दी उन्होंने मेरे मासूम बच्चों को यतीम कर दिया ये लोग नहीं है दरिंदे हैं दरिंदे हैं इनको सजा दे जिन्होंने मेरे हस्बैंड का मेरे खानदान ऐसा किया
अगर वो तब तक जिंदा रहे तो यही बच्ची होगी जो उनका पोस्टमार्टम करेगी याद रखिएगा ये बेगुनाह खून का जो ये हर्जाना है उनको देना होगा और अलामिया उनको छोड़ने वाला नहीं है
फर्स्ट टाइम एवर द जेएनके पुलिस हैज आस्क्ड इट्स पर्सनल टू अवॉइड प्रेइंग ऑन ईद इन पब्लिक प्लेसेस द एडवाइजरी हैज आस्क्ड द कॉप्स टू ऑफर प्रेयर्स एट ईदर मॉस इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट पुलिस लाइंस और इन प्रोटेक्टेड प्लेसेस दिस इज फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट सच एन एडवाइजरी हैज बीन इशूड एंड द पुलिस सेज दैट इट इज अ प्रिकॉशनरी मेजर
मीनवाइल इन गोरखपुर अनदर फैमिली हैज प्लंज्ड इनटू ग्रीफ सब इंस्पेक्टर साहब शुक्ला वाज शॉट डेड बाय टेररिस्ट आउटसाइड अ स्कूल इन श्रीनगर ऑन फ्राइडे
कि मेरा पति तो शहीद हो गया लेकिन मैं अपने चारों बेटों को भी उसी में भेज दूंगी कि मेरे चारों बेटे भी देश के लिए कुछ काम करते हैं
All eyes are on the crucial Modi-Trump meeting on Monday on what action can Modi convince Trump to take against Pakistan and its proxies action which the families of martyrs in India are desperately seeking Vishujal Haq and Asutosh in Srinagar Bureau Report India Today.
Joining me now on the broadcast is Shabnam Lone, activist lawyer, and also joining us is Gopal Agarwal, national spokesperson of the BJP. Shabnam Lone, coming to you first. You heard those cries. You heard those wife, that mother, saying that they want LET, Lashkar-e-Toyba terrorists, to be eliminated, to be thrown out of the valley. What gives the legitimacy to people like Mirwais, Umar Farooq, those who still justify what happened outside Jamia Mosque?
Well, Ankit, let me say, I can't hear him.
Shabnam, go
Ankit,
ahead.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can. I can. Please go ahead.
Can you hear me?
I can. Please go ahead.
Okay. Well. Well, let me say. If I were to say, where do I come from? Well, I come from the valley of frozen fear. I come from the valley of frozen justice. Now, I have seen these heart-rending sights that you shown me of my Kashmiri sisters, mothers, and children in deep grief. It is ironical that none of us have got justice in Kashmir. If you recall, Ankit. My father too was killed in a dastardly terrorist attack when he was invited by the Mirwais. He was in America at that time. He was invited by the Mirwais to attend Mirwais's father's, 14th death anniversary in Nowhatta. My father was brutally gunned down. But I fear whether these families will get justice because the state has been very ambivalent. To give justice to the common Kashmiri. Can you imagine? Okay. My father was gunned down before thousands of people. No case was ever filed in that. His trial never took place. If the trial of a stature of a leader of Abdul Ghani Lone, his assassination, if that could not take place, I wonder whether these families will ever get justice. Yes, you are correct. Mirwais has to own up to this responsibility. He must own up. He must help the police in identifying these killers. These killers have to be identified.
Gopal Agarwal, let me just quickly come to you, and before I go back to Shabnam Lone, Gopal Agarwal, the question is straight to you. You, BJP, is a part of the government in Jammu and Kashmir. The question is straight to the government, not only in Srinagar, but also in Delhi. Will these families receive justice? It's not only, Shabnam Lone, it's not only enough for Mirwais to own up and identify. Mirwais is as culpable as those people, those who brutally killed this policeman, the deputy superintendent. What are we waiting for, Gopal Agarwal? Why is the security of Mirwais not being taken back? Why do we not see all these people behind bars?
No, actually, the government, Modi government, has given the free hand to the CRPF and local administration on army to deal with the law and order situation.
Let me interject you right there. Are you saying that the state government is not doing its duty? You are also a member of that state government. Pull out of that state government if it's not doing its duty.
No, it is not alone the duty. You see, the Kashmir is a very difficult situation. We had seen earlier policy of being soft on the terrorists, and these kind of activities have led to a situation.
Gopal Agarwal, come on, let's not talk about past. It is happening right in front of you. You are in power at the center, and you are in power in Srinagar. Please don't tell me what the Manmohan Singh government or what the previous government in Srinagar did. We are talking about what happened just 2 days back. Why doesn't the decisive Modi government take an action right now? Demolish this Republic of Mirwais, Umar Farooq and Nohata.
We are all... Definitely the steps will be taken, but at present the problem is that we have to first tackle the hardcore terrorist activities which are being perpetrated across Kashmir. That is more important. First, we have to close the border, seal the border, cross-border infiltration does not take place. You cannot open all fields, sectors at the same time. Army is dealing with
Shabnam
the
Lone, the response that I seem to be getting.
Sir, what are you saying? The response that I seem to be getting is that the government possibly
will wait for more such activities before they take a decisive action against the separatists.
No,
it is not.
Ankit,
let Shabnam Lone
justice is most important. No, you have a country's Home Secretary. I'm sorry.
I heard the Home Secretary's
message that, he said that lynching. That lynching of DSP Pandit, it has been overhyped by the media. I have a question for the Home Secretary of India. Do you know how your statement has demoralized the entire police force in the state? Do you know ordinary citizens who have been crying for justice to all these people? Do you know how much you have demoralized them? Does it mean that you do not want to catch the perpetrators?
Okay.
It is easy to catch them. Ask Mirwais. Ask his people to identify them. Mirwais is the one who can help you. Stop shielding Mirwais. Mirwais, you are the imam of that mosque. You take responsibility. Own up. You misfired once.
I am in complete concurrence with what she's saying.
Definitely.
Get Mirwais to identify all those people. Yes. Mirwais, as I've been saying, is equally culpable in this heinous act.
But for anything to be clearly demarcated, it has to be proved. Ultimately, the government, the police and the army...
What are you saying, Gopal Agarwal? These are videos. What needs to be proved? A man was lynched. crowd outside a mosque. There are videos. What needs to be proved?
Man has been killed.
On one hand, the BJP says that we have a very strong hand approach. Is this the strong hand approach?
Strong hand approach is towards the militants and towards the terrorist activities which are being
committed. Are you telling me that those men who lynched a DSP on duty, they are not terrorists?
Ankit, I protest the BJP statement.
No,
BJP
definitely.
Cannot
the
make
police
such a
has
statement.
Already.
What are they saying? He's saying that we will make other people to get killed.
Police has already arrested.
They are doing billions of dollars of business with Pakistan.
Sentiment.
No, what? Two arrests? No. Two
Pakistan
arrests don't make
it right, sir. There are
arrest those entire perpetrators of injustice, murder, and mayhem. This is what you did in my father's case. This time, the entire Kashmir
will
speak up.
These will
you
be taken
must
care
catch
of.
These murderers.
No, but
India, you betrayed justice to me.
Okay.
India, this is a Kashmiri daughter saying, give
Gopal Agarwal, Shabnam,
just stay
on.
Let me, Shabnam, who are getting killed.
Shabnam, let me ask you this question. Of course, as of now, it just seems that the spokesperson of the BJP is completely out of words to answer. I'm appalled by what you were saying, Mr. Gopal Agarwal. These men, those who brutally lynched
the
DSP, they are as equal bad terrorists as a Lashkar-e-Toyba man who opened fired on a CRPF convoy and killed that sub-inspector. Shabnam Lone, my question to you now would be, seeing all this, isn't it time that people like you, isn't it time that the others from the Kashmiri society now should openly come out and speak against people like Mirwais Umar Farooq? They are the ones, those who are instigating such mobs. He was the one who came, even after this lynching, sat down on his dais and continued the sermons without even once mentioning the brutal way in this man was killed. Forget that he's a policeman. Forget anything else. He's a Kashmiri who was killed by his fellow Kashmiri. His house is just few meters away from that mosque.
Yes, I am. I agree with you. Mirwais made not only a mistake. Mirwais, as a good Muslim, do justice now. You were ceremonizing in that mosque, Mirwais. You did not. How did you ceremonize in that mosque when a most dastardly murder took place right there in front of the mosque? Mirwais, it's time for you. Now do something for Kashmir. You are answerable to the people. If they have trusted you,
Shabnam, shouldn't this be the time when people
trust,
like Mirwais Umar Farooq, Mr. Gilani, those who are not only politically and religiously giving legitimacy to these such acts, isn't it the time that these people be thrown off the high chairs that they sit on?
Ankit Tyagi, can I come?
I'll come to you. I'll come to you, Mr. Agarwal.
Who has asked the government to mollycoddle? Now, who has asked the government to be sugar-coated where rules of justice and procedure are concerned? Did the common Kashmiri tell them that you leave A, B, C or D? This government is playing double games. They have been playing double games for the past 20 years. I don't know what's wrong with the BJP. Congress, National Conference and PDP have been at these games. BJP now can do something. Mr. Modi is a powerful leader at the center. Why do they need to bend to these people? If they think they want to retain power in Jammu and Kashmir, this is not the way.
Why a strong leader like Prime Minister Narendra Modi is not taking a decisive action is the question that Shabnam Lone is asking the BJP. I'll get Gopal Agarwal to respond to this. I have to slip into a very short break. Gopal Agarwal, after the break, answer Shabnam Lone's question. Why a man who is so powerful, who enjoys absolute majority, why is he not taking a decisive action on bodies of policemen every single day, of the security personnel, those who are under attack from the terrorists, and this time not only terrorists, but people outside the mosque have lynched a deputy SP. Gopal Agarwal of the BJP and Shabnam Lone are on the broadcast with me. Gopal Agarwal, before I went into the break, Shabnam Lone had a question for you. Why a strong prime minister who claims that he will teach not only Pakistan but everybody against India a lesson, Why does he seem so helpless? Why are we not seeing decisive action against Mirwais and people like him?
No, actually, if we, Kashmir is an old problem, we have to understand the issues. There are several players in the Kashmir problem. One is the Pakistan. One are the persons who directly indulge in terrorist activities. There is a support system like Suryat and other leaders who are Indians, but they are supporting that ideology. Then there are innocent people of the Kashmir, students and other who are misguided and take part into these agitations. And there is a Kashmiri Pandit. These are five different categories of people, and our government has to deal in a comprehensive way with all these.
Gopal Agarwal,
issues.
Do you know why we I let you complete your Kashmir, argument? Because I just Pakistan wanted people to understand how the BJP spokesperson right now has not been able to answer the question that I asked him, but is only trying to ensure that we digress from the topic. Shabnam Lone, last word to you. Last word to you. Go ahead, Shabnam Lone.
No, I'm telling you.
Ankit, I am so shocked by this response. It is essentially a case of justice.
It's an important
issue.
Does
it mean that now that these cases will be fought in the Pakistan High Court? Do we seek justice from the Supreme Court of Pakistan now? Where should we go?
I am
seeking justice against those killers who killed my father. I am seeking justice against those who lynched Ayub. Those
there
who make our mothers and daughters cry.
CRP is one.
No,
army
you give
is
us
another.
Justice.
Police
you give
is
us
another.
Do we
and
go
the
to the
government,
Pakistan
local
Supreme
government,
Court?
And the central
what
government.
What is the due process of
no,
law?
No, I would just now coming in between, and I will request both my guests to just stay on for a moment. Shabnam Lone. Ashok Agarwal, you know, the question, Mr. Agarwal, is, and this is exactly what Shabnam Lone is pointing out, until and unless people of Kashmir get basic necessities, they get basic justice from the government, which as of now seems to be failing them, not only in Srinagar, but also in New Delhi, the problem is only going to compound. I thank both my guests for joining me on this debate. It's important, at least, for voices in Kashmir to come out and ensure that those who are against the state, those who are against their own, are isolated, and for the government in Delhi to make sure that those who are against the state, those who are raising their voice, those who are indulging in such acts of brutality are made to pay. Well, let's give you a quick update of the encounter that started near the Pantha Chowk on Saturday. Finally, it has ended. 24 hours long gun battle between the security forces and the terrorists ended this morning. The Pak-based Lashkar-e-Toyba claimed responsibility for the deadly attack, yet again in a series of attacks to keep the valley burning. Can Pakistan still paint itself innocent?
A deadly terror attack on the outskirts of Srinagar city. This school building became the center of the attack, which was launched late on Saturday. The fierce gun battle began after two to three terrorists ambushed a CRPF bus near Pantha Chowk on Saturday evening. Minutes later, security forces cordoned off the area. As terrorists used this prestigious Delhi public school as an escape route, soon enough, locals emerged throwing stones at the security forces. Almost 24 hours later, two terrorists were eliminated. Two AK-47s recovered from the encounter site. CRPF officer Sahab Shukla was martyred in the terror attack. Three army men received serious injuries. The attack was yet another strike aimed at men in uniform. It came days after Deputy Superintendent of Police Ayub Khan was lynched by a frenzied mob outside Jamia Mosque. The Pak-based Lashkar-e-Toyba claimed responsibility for the brazen attack, yet another in a series of attempts to keep the fire of unrest alive. With Shujaul Haq and Ashutosh Mishra in Srinagar, Bureau Report, India Today.